A very good day to all of you. As all of you know, on the first day of the week, you learn something new, and in the next class, we revise the same. So today, you will practice what you learned. Let us now begin the revision of the previous class. Can you tell why we use the spelling option? With the spelling option, you can check the spelling of the text that you have typed. If you have typed a wrong spelling for some words, then you can correct the same with the spelling option. Can you tell why we use the gallery option? With the gallery option, you can get different types of graphics on your slide. With the help of the gallery option, you can also get many images and can also change the slide background. Can you tell what is the shortcut command to run the slideshow? To run the slideshow, you need to use the F5 command. Why do we use custom animation? With custom animation, you can get many different effects on your slide or on any object. For example, you might have seen in a film that its name comes on the screen from different directions. This effect is applied with the help of the custom animation option. What happens with close window? With close window, you can close the current file or current window. What happens with hide slide? With hide slide, you can hide your slide. Let us now begin today's class. Now, all of you switch on your computers and open the Impress file with the method taught to you. Have you all been able to open the file? Let us begin revising what we learned in the previous class. Now, as a first step, you need to insert 5 slides. You will be doing different types of work on each of the slides. In the first slide, type out the paragraph being shown to you. If you like, you can even change the slide design. If you face a problem, then watch the video and learn from it. With the help of this video, let us now see how we can change the design of our slide. So to change the design of our slide, bring the pointer into the slide layout area, which is on the right side of the slide, and click on master page. We click on master page and a number of styles or a number of slide types open up. Click on the one which you like, and as soon as you click, you will see that it gets applied, the slide design gets applied to your slide. In the next slide, insert any picture of your choice. If you face a problem, then watch the video and learn from it. Let us now practice inserting a picture in our presentation. To insert the picture, as you all know, we need a blank new slide. So let's go to the slide pane, click there, right click on it, and then you can click on new slide. So a new slide opens, which is in the design that you had originally selected. Whenever you select a new slide, it opens with that design. Click on properties in the slide layout and then click on blank layout. So the blank slide will appear. Since you want to make it totally blank, click on master page and then click on the default option and apply to selected slides. So the default of blank slide will get applied to this slide. Now, since we want to insert a picture on this slide, we take our pointer to the insert menu and left click on that. From the submenus that are available to you here, bring your pointer to the picture submenu and click on from file option. Here you should know which picture you want to pick from which location. So if we click on downloads, there are some files available. So if let's say if we click on one of these pictures and click on open, you will see that in the box it says graphics file not found, because it was not a graphics file. So just click on OK, go back to insert, come to picture and click on from file. Now let's see where we can find pictures. So for instance, we have clicked on various options here, music, but music does not have any pictures here. Then we'll try in the pictures location, and you can see some sample pictures. Click on that and many pictures are available here. Now click on the picture that you like, that you want to insert, and click on the open button. So that picture gets inserted on your slide. In the next slide, type about your friend. If you face a problem, then watch the video and learn from it. Let us now insert a new slide in our presentation and type about our friend. So to insert a new slide, go into the slide pane, click there, right click on it, and then click on new slide. So the new blank slide is available. Since we want to make it a title slide, click on the slide layout properties and click on the title slide option. So a title slide appears. Bring your pointer to where it says click to add title. Once you click there, you can give a title. We are giving a title like type few lines about your friend. You can type any title that you like. Type few lines about your friend, or you can type few lines about my friend, and then you click on the area, main area of the slide. Now type a few lines by yourself about your friend and then show it to your teacher. And then in the next slide, draw any image you like and type out a line about it. Leave the last slide blank. Type out the given line and then correct it by using the spelling option. If you face a problem, then watch the video and learn from it. With the help of this video, let us now practice the use of the spelling submenu or the spell check. So we see that on our slide some words have been typed with the wrong spelling. Now we need to correct them. So to correct them, bring your pointer to the tools menu of the menu bar and click on the spell check option. The shortcut command for spell check is F7. Once you click on the spell check option, a box opens and you can see that the first word on the slide which is wrong in spelling gets selected in this window and is shown in red here. In the suggestions, the correct spellings, various words are given which are close to happy. So now we select the correct spelling of happy and then we click on change. As soon as you click on change, you will see that in our slide the correct spelling of happy has been inserted and the next wrongly spelt word gets selected here in red. So it is apple. Now we have to look for the correct spelling of apple. Select that and click on change. Again, you can see on the slide the correct spelling has come and the next word which is wrongly spelled, school, has come here. We select the correct spelling and click on change. So the correct spelling gets inserted in our slide. The next wrongly spelled word is computer. So we have to look for the correct spelling in the suggestions. Click on the correct spelling and then click on change so that the correct spelling gets inserted in our slide. The next word is mobile. So click on the correct spelling and click on change. And then when it says spell check is complete, click on OK. So this is how you can use the spell check feature to correct spellings of your text. Now show how you will insert some shape or graphics from the gallery into the blank slide. If you face a problem, then watch the video and learn from it. Let us now watch this video and practice the use of gallery to insert pictures in our slide presentation. To insert a picture, we first need a blank slide. So go to the slide pane, click on that, and then click on new slide option. So you get a new slide. Since you want a blank slide to insert a picture, go to the layouts and click on blank slide layout. So you get a blank slide. Now to insert a picture, take the pointer to tools and select the gallery option. Since you don't see the gallery right now, after clicking, we will go ahead and do it once more. Go to tools, select gallery, and you see the gallery option has opened. There are many themes here, and in this first theme, the arrows are shown. If we look for environment, we can click on the tab and right click on it so that the insert option comes. And then you can click on copy option because we want to copy this image on our slide. Now you can hide the gallery option by taking your pointer to the dots here or from the tools menu by clicking on gallery again. Now we need to type text about this picture. We need to type a line. So we will first resize this image, make it smaller to suit our need. So you can click on the image and use the green dots to resize. Now because in the blank slide, if we want to type text, we need to select the text tool. So we select from here and then we click on our slide. A small box appears and then we can start typing our text. So we are typing save water, save life. So similarly, you can insert any picture from the gallery and type a line of your choice. So this is how you will use the gallery option. Next, apply custom animation on the text of each of these slides. If you have a doubt, watch the video and then apply custom animation. Let us now practice applying custom animation to our text and images and objects in our presentation. To apply custom animation, we first need to select the slide. So let's select the first slide on which we want to apply the custom animation. Once we select the first slide, let us select the text on which we want to apply the custom animation. So as is being shown in the video, we are selecting the entire paragraph in the slide, and now on the right side, you already have the shortcut button for custom animation. So just bring your pointer there, and on the star kind of icon, which is for custom animation, click on that and you see all the options for custom animation. Click on add and number of different styles of animation appear. So you can click on the one which you like and then click on OK. And since automatic preview is on, you can see that being applied on your slide. Also, when you click on OK, you can see in the small window on the right side that the animation has been applied. We select the next slide, which is an image. So on the image, we click to select that. And as soon as we click on that, the add button on the right side is available to us. So we bring a pointer and click on add. When we click there, the box opens which shows various styles of custom animation. We select one which is random bars and we click on OK. So this animation has been applied to our image also. Again, we select the next slide, which is a single line title, type few lines about your friend. So we select that so that we can apply the animation on this. After selection, again, we click on add, on the add button, and then from the box that opens, we select one of the custom animations of our choice, like spiral in, and you can see that being applied on our slide, and then we click on OK. So this is how you apply custom animation. Now if you want to see this animation in a slideshow, let us first click on the first slide because we want to begin from there, then take the pointer to slideshow and click on slideshow, and your slide appears in a big screen. Now you can use the up arrow and the down arrow to go further, and once you start using the down arrow, you will see the text appearing on this slide and the custom animation being applied on it. Again, if we click on down arrow, the next slide appears. Click on down arrow and you will see the random bars custom animation being applied on your image. Again, down arrow and you can see the third slide and so on. If you click down arrow, fourth and fifth slide without the animation because we did not apply. To get out of the big slide, you have to press on the escape button, ESC button on your top left corner of your keyboard. So this is how you apply custom animation. Now show how you will hide the slide and then show how you will run the slideshow. Next, go ahead and use new window to bring up a new current file. Show how you will close the current file. Today's class ends here. Close your file and properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you practiced what you learned in the previous class, like why do we use spelling? Why do we use gallery? How can we view our slide in a larger screen or full screen? What happens with slideshow settings? What happens with custom animation? How do you hide a slide? How do you bring up a new window? How do you close a window? Thank you.